All right, we're going to continue working with xAPI and Storyline. And in the last video, if you haven't checked it out already, the last video I showed you how to send over xAPI statements to a course that's internal, meaning that it's loaded inside of a learning management system that can handle xAPI data. So if you haven't checked that one out, go ahead and check that one out so you at least know how to add the statements and send that over. But now we're going to be talking about sending it over to a learning record store, an external learning record store, meaning that your content and your courses could really be anywhere. They don't have to be loaded inside of a learning management system. Your learners don't have to go to one location to launch the course. They could really take this course anywhere and have the xAPI data sent over. So we're going to cover how to do that next. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at LearningDojo.ninja. You can check out my blog with all previous posts that I have. You can check out templates with Storyline and xAPI templates. You can also check out courses with Articulate Storyline 360, full courses with everything you need to know about Storyline, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. So we covered how to actually trigger over the statements, and I'm going to review what we did in the last video real quick. So I have this 4-page course. You can see a page title, a regular page layout. You can also see a tab interaction that we learned about, and then exiting the course. Now on the regular page layouts, we sent over a statement when the timeline starts. If I double click on that, I'm basically sending over a statement, and it's going to send over this custom xAPI statement. And I can name that to something else if I wanted to. I can go ahead and change the name there. And this is sending over an experienced, and it's gonna grab the slide title. I can add on additional stuff within there if I wanted to as well. And so I'm gonna click OK. And we're doing the same thing here. It's gonna basically send over that the learner experienced this page name, 1.255 layout. If I wanted to come in here, and then click on this, I could go into the custom, and instead of having it 50-50 layout, I could change it to something else if I wanted to there. So keep that in mind. And then the tab interaction, we came over here and it's gonna send over an xAPI statement, the learner interacted with tab one. We had a little bit of a problem though inside of the learning record store. If you come into the learning record store, instead of tab one, it actually ended up being group. Now I don't know if it actually added a tab one later on, but we may want to change that to something different. So I'm going to double click on this one here. And instead of, well, not that one, we're going to go into the xAPI statements. Instead of interacted with tab one, we're going to go ahead and add this custom text of tab one. Hopefully that gives us more data, but I'm going to click OK there. Now I'm going to come into here and in the xAPI statements, instead of just grabbing that object, we're gonna go ahead and say custom text tab two. Before, it would just grab the object automatically, which was a group. It had a bunch of content grouped together. So that's why it just says group. So I'm hoping that shows up there. All right, now we have that final page, which basically just sends an exit course. And as soon as the timeline starts, it's gonna send over that they've completed course 101. Right here, you can see here, completed course 101. Everything is good. We have the xAPI statements that we created in the last video. Again, if you haven't checked that out, check that out so you can understand exactly what we did up to this point. But now we want to send over to a learning record store. Now, inside of SCORM Cloud, they have the ability to send over to an external learning record store, meaning that the content could be really anywhere. The content itself doesn't have to be inside of the system. It can be anywhere. So what we want to do is we want to send it over to this sandbox here. So I need to get an endpoint, but I also need to go into the activity provider and I need to get a key and I need to get a secret. Every learning record store that you work with will have an endpoint and a key and a secret, which is basically the username and password, but it's encrypted. And you could put your username and password, but I wouldn't because that is definitely not encrypted. But this is something that you can grab for a little bit more security. And the LRS viewer is how you can start to see information that's coming in. You can see that it also has information from this internal course, and I can see all of that stored inside of this location because it also sends information over to this learning record store. But I want to send it over to the sandbox, so I'm coming into the sandbox here, and I'm going to grab this information. So I'm going to copy this right here, and I'm going to come back into Storyline. When we're about to publish to a learning record store, what we do is come over to the publish section and go into the LMS/LRS section. And instead of it reporting to a learning management system using CMI5, we're going to have this report to an external learning record store. So we're basically going to have this course hosted somewhere else, and it's going to send the data over. I'm going to click on reporting and tracking. We don't need to do anything inside of the LMS section, but this is where we would change the ID and so forth if needed. But I'm going to go into the learning record store section, and instead of it being supplied at launch, we'll talk about what that means, because instead of providing the LRS endpoints and the key and the secret, you can actually have that as part of the launch URL, like the URL that a person goes to view the course, and that way it's not stored anywhere inside of the course. Or you can have it stored inside of the course, and you can come in here and add that endpoint there. And then I can come into the activity provider and I can add this key. I'm going to come in and copy and paste that key in, and I'm going to add the secrets inside of there as well. Now, what you want to do from here is make sure that the connection is okay and that it's able to send over information to this learning record store. So all you have to do is hit test connection, and then it will give you a check mark connected to the LRS if everything is okay. So as long as you're connected and the xAPI statements are formatted correctly, it's going to send over data. I'm going to click OK here, and then I'm going to click on Publish. Now, there is one more thing that I need to do. I have not anywhere in the course identified who the actor is. When the course is inside of a learning management system, it will automatically capture who the person is inside of the learning management system. The problem is this course is not going to be, because we're sending it externally, the course is not going to be inside of a learning management system. So we have a little bit of a problem. You could, just going back here, if I go back into publish, and if I had both of these, it could be inside of the learning management system, but it could also be sending data to another learning record store as well. So that's a possibility, and it will still capture who the person is inside of the learning management system. So even if your learning management system doesn't handle a learning record store or xAPI statements, that's fine. It'll at least capture who the person is through SCORM, and then it will send over the data to this external learning record store. But that the course itself has to still be uploaded to some learning management system. So when we get rid of that option, we now are not able to identify who the person is. And so we have to work around this a little bit in order for us to know who the person is. So if I come into the reporting and tracking and go into this learning record store, there's this little info button right here. And if I click on that info button, it's going to give me some details, including, I scroll down here, this LRS launch test guide. If I click on that, it's going to give me this little tool. Now, this little tool is basically going to give me something that I can add on to the launch URL in order to identify who the person is. And so I have to provide it with some sample data. If I did not put the endpoint and the authentication in, I did in this case, but if I didn't, I would have to put it here as well if you wanted this to just be in the URL that somebody clicks on. But what I want to do is identify the actor. So I click on these three dots, and I'm just going to enter in my name and my email. Now, obviously, not every user is going to be my name and my email, so keep that in mind. But if I click OK here, it's at least going to give me the information that I need down at the bottom. So if I click on copy here, and then I come over to the published course, I'm going to double click on this, and I'm just going to double click on where it says story.html. Notice how in this URL over here, it starts out with story.html, and then it adds a bunch of information after it. But within that information has my name, so you can see Jeff Batt, and it also has my email, so jeffbatt@gmail.com. So it has some important details there. If I add that, so I'm going to get rid of story.html on this URL that pops up, and I add that, it basically adds some information of who the person is. So this is what's called a query string. Now, you can do this from a single sign-on. So you can capture who the person is, and you can grab that little string at the end of the URL, and you can do that as who the person is if they're logged into a single sign-on. So as long as you put it behind like Okta or whatever single sign-on that you're using, you may have to figure out how to do the query string part of it, but you can add that and kind of change it, and that is part of your, that's basically how you launch the page, is by figuring out who that actor is. Without that actor, it's going to throw some errors. So you need to be able to have that query string at the end of it. But now if I come in here and I start to go through my pages and I start to interact with my different tabs and I click on exit course, even though I'm running locally here, I'm running this not on the web, I'm running it through a web browser, but it's basically just on my device here, it's still going to send over xAPI statements. So now if I come into SCORM Cloud, go into this LRS viewer and hit refresh, you can see right here, Jeff Bat interacted with tab one. So by adding that custom text, now we're able to see tab one here. Tab two, exit layouts completed as well. It still has that left. It still has the experience and so forth. So the hardest part when you're sending over the external data is figuring out that actor. And it's basically just, you know, figuring out what the query string is. So what I would do is work with your single sign-on developers and talk to them about getting that query string. If you can talk to them about getting that query string, then you're golden. And typically that would probably be replacing, instead of over here where it says jeffbat@gmail, maybe this is, you know, okta.username or something like that. So as long as this is behind a URL and they're logged into Okta, it's going to pull that up. So again, you might have to figure this part out, but that is at least how you do it. And that's where this tool comes into play, is making it a little bit easier for you to identify who the person is. I'm going to go ahead and close this out. And that's really all that I need to do. It's going to publish to a learning record store. I can click OK. I hit publish. That's, and then I can take these files right here and I can upload this to a web server. You can use like CyberDuck or something like that, upload it to a web server, and then just give that URL with that query string on there, give that URL to people, and it's going to be able to track the data. So the easier way is just putting it inside of a learning management system, but you can still track content that's outside of a learning management system, and this is a whole lot easier than what it used to be as well. If you wanted to check out additional information on this, you could check out my blog. And I do have some blogs on a tool that does make it easy as well than it used to be with Storyline and Captivate, if you wanted to be able to send over xAPI statements. So you can check that out. So it does make it a little bit easier. You can also check out templates and then full courses on xAPI fundamentals, Articulate, Storyline 360, Captivate, Rise, Custom SCORM, and so forth. Hopefully this was useful for you and you're able to send over xAPI statements to an external learning record store. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, but thanks everyone.